All right, Geoff Carter here. I'm excited today. Do you know why? I've just picked him up from the airport. Who, you say? I'll tell you who. The kid from Madrid. It's only Alarno, and he's brought his mate with him. I said, what's he doing here? He said, he's going to help me cook. I said, what's his name? He said, Geoffrey-o. I said, right, well, I'll pick you both up, got them in the car, got the suitcases. They've dumped the suitcases in the back bedroom now. They're already in the back garden getting everything set up today because they're going to make a paella. In England, it's paella. In Spanish, it's paella. So, come on, let's go and say hello to Alarno and Geoffrey-o. Come on. Hola.
Hola.
Buenos dias.
Buenos dias.
Geoffrey-o, we always start today's cooking with a nice bottle of Rio Tinto.
Oh, muy bien. Look at that. A nice, rich, full-bodied wine.
For you, my friend.
Oh, muchas gracias. Ooh, ho-ho. Salud.
Salud. Muchas gracias.
Mucho loco! Oh, I tell you what, it's going to be a good day, this. Ooh. Right, Al, are we going to get to the serious stuff, though?
We certainly are. We'll be cooking today, Geoffrey-o, a Valencian paella.
All right, what's that then?
Ooh, chicken, pork, special Baja rice.
Wow.
I cannot wait to start cooking this for my friend.
Where are you from, Wales? Okay.
Just south of Birmingham.
All right, so we've got the big burner here. And you've got the big paella dish.
I've
got
the
pan.
22-inch paella dish. You always need a big one. Pan.
Jose, ole.
Okay, Geoffrey-o, we have a paella pan. A nice big paella pan. Okay, so now the pan is hot, we add the olive oil. And then, gently, get it all around to the sides. Be very careful when you do this. Very hot. And then the salt. We put the salt around the edges. The salt helps to season the meat, but it also stops the oil from splashing when we add the meat. Okay, so now we add the meat. Here we have the chicken. Chicken thighs, beautiful chicken thighs. Cut these in the middle.
Beautiful colours. That's what you want, that.
Now we add the pork. Okay, so the idea with the chicken and the pork is everything cooks in the middle. And then you push it out towards the salt, where it picks up the flavours of the seasoning of the salt. And every time you cook in the middle and you add something extra, everything gets pushed to the outside. Okay, so now we're going to push the meat out to the sides, where it meets the salt. It kisses the salt and picks up all the lovely flavours. Look at all those caramelisation in there. And we add the beans. Everything cooks in the centre. Everything's in the centre. Okay, so now we've pushed the beans out to the side. We have the garlic for 30 seconds, and then we carry on with our cooking. So we push it out. Everything cooks in the centre. In with the garlic. Gotta be quick, we don't want this to burn. Whoa, I can smell that, Geoffrey-o. In with the beans. Careful with your beans. Don't want them to break. Now we have the palero, the magic ingredient.
Wow, look at the colours on that. Alarno.
Smoky paprika, Geoffrey-o.
Stereo. Wow. It's coming together now, Alarno.
It certainly is, Geoffrey-o. So now we're going to add 1,200 millilitres of water.
Steamage. Wow, the colour looks great. Sizzle. Yep.
And now we have a special trick. Give it a stir. You don't need to stir this so much. Give it all a nice stir. And then we'll show you the magic trick. So now, here's the magic. We put this into the 1,200 millilitres of water. You can see that mark. Most important, once we add the rice and the extra water, we boil it down till it gets to this mark again, and paella is ready. Okay, this is the last stir that we give this.
Wow, it's steaming.
I know. Look at the colours. We add this last bit of water.
Yep. Another jug full.
Here's where the magic happens, okay? Now we're going to add the rice.
Wow. What type of rice is it?
Geoffrey-o, we have Bahia rice.
Right, why?
It's a special round rice, specially made for paella.
Wow.
Grown for paella in Valencia.
Wow.
So, here we go.
Come on then.
Special way of putting this rice in. We do it as a cross.
Yep. That way.
And back across.
Oh, very good. I never knew that.
There we go. And that now allows us to give it its final stir. And then we don't touch it.
That looks amazing.
Just make sure everything's nice and shallow. And all the rice is covered.
And how long do we cook that for now?
About 15 to 18 minutes. We're back to the magic stick.
All right.
When this water is evaporated.
To that marker.
To that marker. Paella is ready to eat.
So what are we going to do now then while we're waiting?
We're going to make some sangria.
First of all, we've got a bottle of Rioja. Let's get that in. Glug. We might as well use the full bottle today. Because me and Alarno are going on one today. And why not? It's a lovely day. We've then got a bit of Cointreau for a little bit of orange taste. Glug. That's enough of that. And then finally, we're going to use some best brandy. Let's get that in. Glug. And then we're going to put some ice in. Like that. And then we're going to put some lemon in. Like that. Some orange. And some apple. And now the lemonade. Oh, look at that. Fizzy. Oh. Keep going, a little bit more ice, and then we're going to give it a good stir. Wow, look at that now, full of flavour. It's got brandy, it's got Cointreau, it's got red wine, Rioja from Spain. It's got all the green apples, oranges and lemons, and full of ice. The only way to try it is to drink it. Wow, fantastic. Even the sun's coming out. Okay, calor. Right, and do you know what? Most of the alcohol remains in the fruit. I bet you didn't know that. And if you put it in your fridge overnight, it becomes twice as potent. Let's just get some of that juice now. Wow, look at that, Al. Look at that. Okay, let me know what you think, Alarno.
Geoffrey-o.
Oh,
wow.
Fantastico.
Whoa, rocket.
Super Mario.
Rocket fuel.
Wow, we'll sleep tonight.
Well, I can use it to stick my moustache on. I've got alopecia.
Unbelievable. He's gone through four moustaches now. What's wrong with you?
I'm over the heat. It's unsticking me moustache.
Alarno is unstickable. Ole. Right, listen. We're having a great time there on that sangria. Unbelievable, that. That's better than you can get in Benidorm or wherever, isn't it? It's fantastic there. But Alarno's just said to me, hey, we've not finished the paella yet. I said, why? He said, there's some extra ingredients we've got to put in. So let's check out the final ingredients, and then the proof of the pudding is in the eating, because the rice is nearly ready.
Amigos, the last stages of the paella. Here we go, little taste test first.
Ooh, look at that. Watch, you don't burn your moustache.
Whoa, lovely. Okay, that's nearly ready. So now what we add this beautiful rosemary.
Oh, you put a load of them in, do you?
Oh, yes. Just pull them in.
Doesn't matter.
There we go. Throw that in.
He doesn't care now. He's been on the sangria.
Sangria is very good. Just throw it in.
Hey, they're nice, how you've made them.
Smell that. Geoffrey-o, can you smell that?
Yes, I can, Alarno. Get the lemons in.
Lemons in next.
Uno.
Put them up.
Dos.
One up.
Tres.
One up.
Cuatro.
One down.
Okay. And you season it.
We need to season. I've just tasted. Now a little pepper.
Black pepper.
Nice black pepper, and then...
And white salto.
Salt.
Yep.
There we go. Just throw the salt in.
Wow.
There we go.
Now then.
Do not stir. Paella nearly ready with magic stick.
Righto, just a couple of more momentos, and I'm here with Alarno.
Arima, arima.
How's your moustache?
It's okay on one side, the other side's a little bit...
Luso.
Lucio.
Anyway, listen, it looks like it's going to rain now. We've been lucky, haven't we?
Been very lucky. No umbrella-o.
Hey, not yet. Not yet-io. So let's get drunk-io.
Absolutely. If you're no sure, just put a no on the end.
And you know what it's called?
Sangrio.
It's come off again. It's called embarachada.
Ah.
Or embaracha.
Geoffrey-o, you're very good at Spanish.
That's because I used to eat lots of licorice as a kid.
Oh, did ya?
Yeah. Anyway, listen, we're blagging on. We've only got a couple of more minutes now before the magic test. And once the steak goes in and it's the right depth, we're going to start eating some of the paella.
Oh, yes. The stick test.
I'm not taking him anywhere again. It's game over today, this. Look at it.
Ah, my friends. Okay, so, magic stick. The paella should now be ready. Oh, look at that, amigos.
Yep.
So now all the water's been absorbed. The paella is ready to serve. So now, just a final squeeze of lemon. And we use the other two for garnish. It's a personal choice.
Okay, Alarno, over to you.
Geoffrey-o, so what we're going to do now, we just remove the rosemary. We do serve paella with the rosemary in, okay? We discard it. We just remove the rosemary. All gone. All gone.
Yep.
And then we'll plate up.
Right, Alarno, let me first thank you for making that. That looks absolutely fantastic. But I tell you something, I always say this, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. Mm. It might look good, but does it taste good? Let's try it out, the pair of us. Whoa, here you are. Egg.
That is nice, that, isn't it? Mm. Hey, I'm not just saying it because I've cooked it. This is absolutely magnifico.
Wow.
It's a pork like, Geoff.
It's just like porkio.
Porkio?
Oh, it's melting in your mouth.
Oh, yeah. So, and the other lemons that we had in the pan,
you
used to squeeze over.
Right. Oh, yeah. Oh, beautiful, that, Al. Right then, Alarno.
Geoffrey-o, can I just say something? Sorry to interrupt. See these little burnt bits at the bottom? That's what they call soccer rat.
All right.
So, right at the end of the cooking process, turn the heat right up for 30 seconds. Caramelises the rice at the bottom. It's the best part.
Oh, it tastes gorgeous. It's got that smoky taste.
Absolutely, Geoff Reno.
Well, all I can do, Alarno, is thank you, O.
No problem, O.
Unbelievable, innit? Anyway, listen. We're going to finish this video here now, right? What's wrong with you? Has it fell off again? I've had enough of him by now. Anyway, listen. Hop across to Alan's channel, The Green Team. I'll leave a link at the end of the video. I'll also leave in the description box, I'll leave his link there as well. He's going to tell you how you can get free tapas in Benidorm. How about that? Would you like to go to Benidorm and with every drink you get a free tapas?
You do, you certainly do.
You do. So, agadoo, push pineapple, shake the tree. Don't forget to leave your comments below. And yes, they were plastic straws. And the answer is, bothered. Right, listen, leave your comments below. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up or give us a thumbs down. But that was 10 out of 10.
Cheers, Geoff Reno.
Yep, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the little bell because we love it when you do that. And us two now, you know what we're going to say.
Keep smiling.
Oh, God, I've not took my moustache off yet. And the main thing is,
keep smiling.